Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Shivam Vijay. Today, in this video, I am going to giving a demo on LED TV trainer. LEDs are the most commonly used electronic devices nowadays in the households, in any other institutions, and many more the places at where we require to see the audio-video signals and to compile them through a display on a monitor like this. In this video, we are going to see the different working functions of LED television. In this, the complete block diagram of LED, working of the LED and difference of the LED with the other type of TVs like LCD, display TVs and plasma, also the old CRT type of TVs are also described in this video. I will also try to explain the concept of LED and the advantages of LED TV right now, and also we will try to simulate the different test points at the different signals. Also we will see all the fault conditions by using the fault switches provided in this complete trainer board. So now I am going to describe all the main features of this trainer kit, and later on we will also follow the experiments as given in the user manual. So this is the complete trainer kit of LED TV trainer. The order code is 10937. You can use this order code to find out all the specification or what you can learn from this by visiting our website, which is www.tescaglobal.com. So this is a complete metal enclosure design and very attractive design. To see the complete details of the LED TV trainer, we'll open the front box of this, and here we are getting all the different types of block diagrams of the LED TV trainer. Also, the complete block diagram is explained on the front side for understanding of different block working and functions. So this is the complete block diagram you can see on the front screen right now. So this is the basic kit of the complete LED setup. We have differentiate all the parts on the different blocks over here. We will study all the blocks one by one in the experiment, and we will see the different blocks of the complete TV controller also. So we are also offering the LED with backlit TV with this a display. All the components can be connected with the display on the trainer board. And display has the 24-inch diagonal size flat panel LED display with the 1366x768 of the aspect ratio, and the screen type is LED with backlighting, and response time is 8 milliseconds. For the image, brightness is about 280 per meter square and contrast ratio is about 5000:1. Maximum horizontal viewing angle are 160-176 multiplied by vertical viewing angle is about also 176 degree. And for the interface, analog video input is about RGB VGA HD15 is given with this. Analog video input is about S video, standard videos, and composite video input is also supported with the interface RCA yellow, and audio input for RCA left and right with the red are given here. And audio input is about RCA left and right, and antenna RF input with SDTV and PAL format are given. Tuner channels are about 2 to 69, and screen display menus are about for using volume, brightness, contrast, color, channel and tuning. Remote control function, on screen display of volume, brightness, contrast, channel are given, and all the different using keyboard blocks are also provided with the power, channel, plus and minus button. Then we have volume, plus and minus key. Then for source key and the menu key are also on board given. And there are also on board blocks for USB block, audio video block, antenna input block, PC audio in block, display block are given to understand all the visualizing different blocks. We will understand all the blocks one by one in the experiment given within the user manual. Also, the complete trainer board has the 62 test points where different points we can see the different voltage value and different signal values on the test points. Also, we have provided 57 fault switches with different sections and different blocks to visualize the common fault conditions in the LED TV circuit. And the complete trainer board works on the 230 volt 50 hertz power supply AC source, and you can connect the power cord on this right side of the section. There is a slot on the right side and there is a button to turn on and off the trainer board. The power LED will indicate the power on conditions. We are also offering the user manual in which all the details about the LED TV trainer, all the specifications, advantages, disadvantages, and the comparison between LCD, LED and CRT type of monitors are also given. You can detailedly study all the functions and features of the LED TVs right now using. So in the experiment 1, we are going to study the specification of HDTV. The concept of complete HDTV working and what is the HDTV is given. In the user manual, you can study it in detail. And there are HDTV may be transmitted in various formats, as we can see 1080p, which have the resolution of 1920x1080, which have around 2.07 megapixels per frame. So these are the different standards, and different progressive scan is indicating the P is indicating the progressive scan for the resolution, and I will indicate the interconnected design. All the detailed specifications or the detailed study is given in the user manual. You can study it properly and to see what are the different display resolutions and formats are supported for the HD and the high definition television, frame size, scanning system, frame rates, all the details are given. You can study it with the user manual. We move on to our next experiment in which we will see all the block diagram and working principle of the trainer board. Now moving on to the next experiment in which we will study the block diagram and working principle of the trainer. So the following details of each block used in the trainer are given in the user manual. We will study all the details one by one. And for the power supply block, this is the power supply block. The first block of power supply is given. We use a digital multimeter to see the different voltage signals. Before that, we will connect the trainer board with the 230 volt power supply, as I have connected it already, and turn on the trainer board by using the on off switch. So I am going to turn on the trainer board. So as I turn on the trainer board, the LED or the power LED is indicating the power is on. Now to turning on the complete TV blocks, we need to press the power button, but before that we can see the power supply or the internals for the internal circuitry is already provided. Set the digital multimeter on the DC voltage measurement, and now we will connect the test probe black on the TP4, which is ground for this, and the red one by one on all the test points. So this is the plus 12 volt test point, and which is showing on the digital multimeter, which is plus 12 volt DCs. Then we have plus 5 volt test point. So this is showing the power supply of 5 volts. Then we have plus 3.3 volt DC for the power supply. So these are the three supplies which are required in the complete circuitry of the LED TV. We will see all the supply and test points one by one. Now moving on to the next block, which is the keyboard block. We will study the keyboard block in which there are different types of keys which are given. So we will start with the power. This key used to on off the trainer or the complete circuitry of the LED. Then this is the menu key. This key used to select the different features of the monitor. So monitor display will be adjusted by the different features. Using the menu key, we can adjust all the different features, in which the features like picture, in this mode user can view select the following options as per their need. पिक्चर मोड, कॉन्ट्रास्ट, ब्राइटनेस, कलर, टिंट, शार्पनेस, कलर टेम्परेचर, नॉइज़ रिडक्शन आर द डिफरेंट फीचर्स फॉर द पिक्चर मोड. देन वी हैव साउंड मोड. इन दिस मोड यूजर कैन व्यू और सेलेक्ट द फॉलोइंग ऑप्शंस एज पर देयर नीड, लाइक साउंड मोड, ट्रेबल, बेस, बैलेंस एंड ऑटोमेटिक वॉल्यूम कंट्रोल. इन द टाइम देर आर ऑल्सो द मोड फॉर टाइम, इन विच यूजर कैन सेलेक्ट द ऑप्शंस लाइक स्लीप टाइमर, ऑटो स्लीप, ओएसडी टाइमर. देन वी हैव ऑप्शन. इन दिस मोड यूजर कैन सेलेक्ट ओएसडी लैंग्वेज, ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम ऑफ द डिवाइस लैंग्वेज, विच इन विच लैंग्वेज यू वॉन्ट टू सी द ऑल फीचर्स ऑफ द मोनिटर. ऑल्सो द एस्पेक्ट रेशियो, एट विच रेशियो यू रिक्वायर और यू वॉन्ट टू सी द डिस्प्ले कंटेंट ऑफ योर टी वी. देन वी हैव की लॉक ऑप्शन. फॉर दिस ऑल द की विल बी लॉक्ड एंड द रीजन लैंग्वेज इन विच रीजन यू आर गोइंग टू यूज द टी वी. यू कैन सेलेक्ट योर रिक्वायर्ड लैंग्वेज एंड एनकोडिंग स्टैंडर्ड्स, रीसेट सॉफ्टवेयर ऑल्सो. सो सॉफ्टवेयर ऑफ द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम ऑफ द डिस्प्ले कैन ऑल्सो बी रीसेट बाय यूजिंग दिस मेन्यू बटन. देन वी हैव सोर्स बटन. By pressing this key, user can select any of the input sources like TV, AV1, AV2, HDMI, PC or media. There are different types of input or hardware also connected on the trainer board, on the trainer circuit. You can select any of the function that you are using for giving the input for the LED TV. Then we have volume plus button. This key used to increase the desired volume or audio volume, and the volume minus button is required to decrease the desired audio volume. Then we have channel plus button, in which the user can change the channel by increasing minor and by negative, or the channel minus, the user can change the channel in decreasing manner. The power LED, 5mm power LED is there to indicate the power on and off. This is a dual color LED. When the power is on, this will turn to green. As I am going to on the power, so this has been now turned to green. This is showing the power signal or the display of the monitor is now on. Then we have IR block. The trainer has onboard IR block. IR sensor is to sense the switch press from the remote control. So this is the IR sensor on the IR block, which is used to sense the remote signal, which is sensed by the monitor, and signal is given to the monitor to set up the desired channel or any other key pressed by the remote control. This is the fault switch. There are 8 different type of dip switches and different values. These are used to control the IR sensor and IR LED so that all the fault switches should be in on position while working with the remote control. Then we have speaker or headphone block or the earphone block. The trainer has onboard earphone block. The block is used to connect the external audio devices such as headphone, speakers to listen the audio. Fault switches SW2 is provided on this block to create the fault and observe the fault effect on the system. So for left and right functions of the headphone or speaker can be differentiated for different right or left speaker functions. And this is the slot over here so that you can connect the speaker input or the speaker pin to this slot and you can get the output of at the speaker. Then we have LED driver block. In the LED driver block, we will study the different functioning and different signals of the LED driver. This is the on-off switch for LED signals. Power supply, so that LED power supply is on through this switch. You can directly turn on and off the LED driver by using this switch provided over here. You can see the power supply output on the test point as well, and there are different fault switches also provided. All the fault switches should be in the on condition while working with the LED driver block. Then we have onboard display board. In which block? The block has a VGA connector, which is used for connecting the PC monitor. If you want to configure the complete monitor with the PC, you can also use this as by using a VGA connector, which is provided on this block. Fault switches are also provided, and different test points are also provided to see the signals of different R, G and B type of signaling. All the different functions features are also explained in the practicals. Then we have video out block. The trainer has onboard video out block. This block has the video out connector, and fault switch 9 is provided for the onboard control of its blocks function. Then we have PC audio in block. I will also explain it. So in the PC audio in block, the trainer has onboard PC audio in block. The block has the audio connector to connect it to the PC. If the trainer has configured with the computer, the input of the PC will be provided through this socket so that you can easily get the output on the monitor with the monitor speaker using the LED TV as a monitor for the PC. Fault switches also provided for taking the different outputs of the input of PC audio in block. Then we have onboard antenna input block. The input block for antenna RF signal from the antenna to feed the RF signal to the TV is used. The antenna ANT input connector or the RF connector is also provided is onboard. Then we have fault switches for positive and ground supply to be discontinued for the antenna input. So we can resemble the actual fault conditions with the antenna input section. Then we have audio video block. The trainer has onboard two audio video block consisting of namely as AV block 1 and AV block 2. These two blocks have the connectors video V1, audio L1, then audio write 1. Then we have V2 for video 2, and then we have AL2 for the left input audio. Then we have AR2 for the right input audio of the second audio video signal. Then respectively for audio and video signal, fault switches are also provided. You can easily terminate all the functions for video and audio signals, and we can resemble the fault commonly comes in the TV section by connecting it with the AV block, any of the audio video input device. Then we have USB blocks, USB block 1 and USB block 2. The trainer has onboard USB block. The block consisting of two USB slots, namely USB 1 and USB 2, used to connect the external storage USB devices such as pen drive, hard drives, or any of the devices which are used with the universal serial bus type of connectors. Fault switches for data and power are given. All the four types of wires can be easily terminated by using these fault switches. So for the fault switches should be in the on condition when you are working with the USB devices. So this is the USB devices block. Then we have the TV controller block. In this block there are two sections, which is high definition multiple interface for the high definition TV. HDMI 1 and 2 is to be connected for that. And then we have DDR memory. This is the inbuilt memory of the complete system to store the operating system of the complete LED monitor, at by which all the functions and booting up of the TV system and features are stored. So this is all the blocks of complete trainer board. Now we will study the next experiment regarding the working of test points, and we'll see the different fault points later on with the next other experiment as well. Now we're moving to the next experiment, in which we will study the working of LED TV trainer. In this, we will follow the procedure as given in the user manual. For that, we have to connect the trainer kit to AC supply that we have already connected. Then we have to connect the 25-pin D-type connector from the LED TV to the LED TV trainer, which will be also provided with the LED monitor. Then we will connect the box type connector with the white dot connecting on pin number 2. We will carefully connect this connector to the PCB of the onboard. Then we set the all fault switches to the on position. Then we power on the supply, and then we see LED working on the LED monitor. So we have connected the trainer board to AC power source. Now these are the two connectors from the LED monitor, which is already inbuiltly provided. So we have to connect this with the trainer kit. So this is the 25 pin D-type connector that should be connected on the connector CN1 on the trainer board. So we will connect it carefully like this. For the proper working, you can screw the bolt provided for the connector. Now you will connect this box type connector matching up the white or the arrow on the box connector to the pin number 2 of the PCB. So we'll see this closely so you can understand how to connect the connector properly on the PCB. So this is the onboard connector. Right now you can see we have to connect this box type connector on the onboard connector of this PCB. So if you can see, there is an arrow on this block. So this arrow should be matched with the pin number 2. Here you can see there is small mark of pin number 1 and there is the mark of pin number 2. Similarly, all the pins are distributed. This is the 29th and the 30th pin. So we have to connect this arrow to the pin number 2. So we'll mention this arrow to the pin number 2 by connecting this connector in this way. So I'm going to connect this carefully. So our connector has been connected properly. If you do not get the output, make sure the connector should be connected in proper way. Now after connecting both the connectors to the PCB and the trainer board, now we will turn on the power by on and off switch of the LED trainer board. Here you can see the power LED is now glowing and showing the red indication that the power to the trainer has been provided. Now to turn on the television or the giving the output from the PCB to the monitor, we will press the power switch. This will turn to green and our monitor will be on. So here you can see this is the blue screen, as there is no input devices connected to the monitor, and our monitor with the complete TV signal is provided. Now we will connect any of the signal to the monitor and to see the output on the monitor screen. So that was the practical demonstration of the LED, how the power and the circuitry works to turn on the LED. Now we will study the basic concept behind the LED trainer so that we can easily understand how the LEDs are now working. Now for understanding the basic principle or working principle of LED television, or we can say LED backlit LCD television, because the basic working of the LCD TVs and the LED TVs are the same. They use the two transparent molecules, light round you can show in the diagram, which is powered by the current or any supply. In this we have filled up the liquid crystal molecules, which are the liquid crystal display, as the term says. The liquid crystal display are in the twisted form. When we applied the power to the both the electrodes, the liquid crystals filled between the two electrodes will change the position and untwist according to the angle and power applied. So when we applied the power, the liquid crystal changes the position, and there is a backlit in the LCD, which is the cold fluorescent lamp. The cold fluorescent lamp will give the rays or the light transmit as per the position of the liquid crystal molecules, and the desired image will be displayed on the front panel. So this is the light which is in the LCD TVs. We were using the cold fluorescent lamps, and in the LED televisions right now we are using the LEDs instead of cold fluorescent lamps. So the LED will give the appropriate light from the back panel or the backlight. This will be refracted and provided on the front panel as per the structure formed through the liquid crystal molecules. So basic concept of LCD and the LED remains the same. For just to hide and light the giving a passage through the light rays so that the image will be appropriately designed on the front panel. So there are some lot of material also used, like color filters. The RGB, red, green and brown subpixels element are also provided, so the light, which is the white in the color, will passes through the subpixels and the color filter. The appropriate color will be provided to the screen and the image will be generated as per the color signals, and the light is passing through the different color filters. After that, there is a polarizer, and the polarized signals are also provided, so we need to require the polarized light to stop and pass the signals. When the signal is passed and stopped and the different wavelengths are provided, we can get the required image on the LED TV monitor, or we can say on the screen. So this is how LED TV works. We using the same concept of LCD TV, but on the place of cold fluorescent lamp as the backlight or the back panel light, we are using LEDs right now, which are more frequently available and less bulkier, thinner, instead of cold fluorescent lamp. Also, these are the nowadays some of the companies and manufacturers making even more cheaper than the cold fluorescent lamp. So LED TVs right now are the revolutionary product in the electronics market to visualize the audio video signals with the high definition picture quality. So that was the brief description and concept of the LED TV working. Now we move on to the next experiment, which is experiment number 4, in which we will study the remote section. The cheapest way to remotely control a device with a visible range is via infrared light. Almost all audio and video equipments can be controlled this way. Due to this widespread use, the required components are quite cheap and readily available. Infrared light is actually normal light with the particular color. We humans can't see the color because its wavelength is about 950 nanometers, is below the visible spectrum. So that's the one of the reason why IR is chosen to remote control for purpose. We want to use it, but we are not interested in the seeing it. So another reason is because IR LEDs are quite easy to make and therefore can be very cheap. Although we cannot see the IR lights by human eyes, but we can also resemble and appropriately see the IR reflective lights on the remote by using the remote like this on the any camera. Right now you can show it, and as I press any of the key on the remote, you will get a LED flicker on the LED light of the IR blaster. So that's how the infrared works, and we can also imagineize and visualize the LED lights or the IR light on the cameras easily. Now we will see the working of remote control. The remote control works on the AAA battery. You can insert the AAA battery by purchasing it at your place, or if we can send it to your country and to your place, we will provide this with the trainer board as well. After inserting the AAA batteries, dry cell batteries of 1.5 volts, the remote is ready to working with the TV. Now, if I press this power button, I will explain some of the functions of the remote as well. So if I press the power button, the LED flicker on the LED light, right now you can see, will be turned green, and there is a flickering also generated when we give the signal from the remote to the trainer board. So for turning on the TV, we will press the red power button and there is a flicker arise, and in some time TV will be on. So that's how remote's working. Now for different functions, like we will press the source button. So you can select any of the different source. There are cursor buttons. So for turning the selection, you can use the cursor buttons. And there are lot of power audio increasing and decreasing functions for the remote is also provided. for trending the channel in increasing and decreasing order, you can use this channel button as well. So that's how remote will be communicating with the LED trainer. IR sensor is also provided on the front panel so that IR light can be easily resembled and get the signals from the remote control. Now moving to the next experiment. In this experiment, we will study the voltages at different test points to measure the test point voltage at different sections. In the LED trainer, user can measure the voltages at different sections. For this, we require trainer kit and the DMM, digital multimeter. We will turn on the power as per the procedure says. Then we set the multimeter at DC voltage mode and connect the negative terminal to the multimeter ground and the positive terminal at to the different test points. On the power supply block, which are given in the table 4.1 over here. In this table, there are different test points given. We will see and observe the accurate voltage, which are voltage and signals are given in the user manual, and we will verify all the test points, signals or the voltages accordingly. So here we have set up the digital multimeter at the DC voltage measurement. Now we will place the negative on the ground terminal, which is TP4, like this, and measure the voltage at different test points. This is TP1. At TP1 we are getting 12.27 voltage in positive. At TP2 we are getting plus 5 volts. At TP3 we are getting plus 3.3 volts. Now this is the power supply block. To measure the other blocks, similarly we will connect the ground to the ground of the power supply block, and the positive probe of the multimeter will be connected at different test points simultaneously. So we will start measuring the voltage from the IR block section. In this, there are different test points are given for IR sensor and for remote working and for the keys working. So we will see the voltages at different points. So at TP1 we are getting 5 volts, at TP2 we are getting 3.3 volts, again 3.3 volts for next, again 3.3 volts for next, 3.3 volts, 3.3 volts for next, 3.3 volts, and at last similar 3.3 volts. So the first signal of 5 volts is going to the IR sensor, to powering on the IR sensor, so that the remote will be communicated with the trainer kit, and the other sensors or other voltages signal are going to the different switches or keys for the keyboard block. If any of the fault switches connected with the test points is off, the simultaneous operation of the key at which the voltage is going will be continuously working in off conditions. So the working of key will be stopped. So we will also observe fault switches in the fault switches practical. Right now we will move on to test the testing voltage or the test point voltage at some more signals. We will see the voltage, which is about 0.01 at this point. Then this is 1.8 volts at this point. This is 0 volts. There is no signal, or maybe the data output. Then similar 0 volts. So there is no signal also. Now we're moving to the USB block. At the USB block, there are 4 main wires or 4 main connections, in which there are plus 5 volt and ground to provide the power to the USB, and then there is 2 wires for communicating data plus and data minus signal. So we'll see the voltage. This is 5 volt plus at the first test point. Now at the second one, there is almost 0 volt. So this is the data negative signal. Then there is almost 0 volt again. So this is data also negative signal. As there is no USB connected, we cannot get any signal from here right now. And this is showing 0 with respect to ground. So this is the ground signal of this USB block. So we will observe some more test points. As the audio devices, antenna and different devices right now not connecting, so we do not have any of the input here, so voltage at these test points will be zero. Now we will measure the voltage at the LED driver circuit. So this is the power circuit of the LED driver, which is giving around 33 volt DC, and this is the ground, so there is almost 0 volts. Now we will observe the voltage at different points of the LED driver output. This is 1 volt, again 1 volt, 1 volt, 1 volts, 1 volt, only 1, almost all the terminals are giving 1 volt output. Now we'll observe the headphones output or the speaker output. Here we are getting 6.4 volt for the speaker output right now. At the other point, similar 6.4 volt also. Now at for the left one, 5.8 volts. 5.8 volts. So this is how all the test points are giving the different values. You can see all the signals and values at different test points and mention them in your observations. Now we move on to the next experiment, in which we will study the different fault conditions with the LED TV. Now moving to the next experiment, we will study the fault switches. This is to demonstrate and understand the different type of faults which occurs in the LED TV. Fault switches are there to make understand the effect of particular switch. Fault switch schemes are protection and function is intended to trip a transmission line breaker when the closed onto a fault line. Dedicated fault switches are available in the various design, but since the fault detecting elements tend to be more sensitive than conventional impedance based line protections functions, they are generally designed to be armed only for a brief period of following breaker closure. Depending on the details of the scheme design and element settings, there may be implications for the line relay loadability. For this, we need a kit, the LED TV trainer kit. Then we follow the procedure, connect the AC supply, press the power switch and make the fault switches as given in the following tables. So there are lot of tables for different blocks. We will see all the fault switches, the dip switches pin number also given. We will see the fault when switch is off, what effects on the LED trainer will be occurs, and also verify this. So we'll start with the IR block. As right now, I will turn on the power using power button, and if I turn the dip switch off of the IR block, the first dip switch, if I turned it off, the power button will not be working. Sorry. For the first switch, the remote control will be not working with the setup. So right now, as you can see, I am using the remote and there is no effect on the LED as well as no effect on the TV. No power on off going on. So remote control is off, as the IR sensor is off by turning off the first pin of dip switch. Now we turn on the dip switch again to the normal condition and off the second key, and this is for the power key. The power key is not work. The power key will not work if we turn off the fault switch 2. Now again we change the dip switch on, and here the power key works. The TV will be on in few seconds. Now at fault switch 3, channel plus or increasing channel key will not be working. There is no effect on the TV right now. And if I press the channel negative key, you will see there is channel difference in the television also. Similarly, for volume increment and decrement, the fault switch 5 will be working. For volume, we will see it on the television monitor screen. So if I press the volume plus button, there is no effect. And if I press the volume negative button, the volume will be decreasing. Here you can see on the television. But if I press plus button, the volume will not be increasing, as we have create the fault conditions for the volume plus key to be suspended. Now similarly for the volume negative key, now volume is increasing, but it will not decrease now because we created fault in the volume decrement key. Now if I press the source key, you can see the source menu is turning on and off on the display. But if I turn off the DP switch F7, the source key will not be working. Sorry, DP7 is for the menu key. For source key, we will use the DP8. Here, DP8. Now I press the source key, the no source menu will be occurred on the screen. And if I press the menu key, here you can see menu for different settings of audio video, you can adjust. But if we turn off the DP switch F7, the menu key will not be working. So that's how we created the different faults in this condition. Now we will connect some of the input devices and see how the audio video and the different faults also creates and occurs on the screen. So now I have connected the USB, a pen drive, to the trainer board. You can see here at the USB section, the USB block. Now if I use the remote and go to source of media, the USB will be loaded and we can see the different contents inside the USB on the TV screen. After reading the USB, this will be the home screen on the television that we get. Here we can select any of the photo, video and movie and the text documents to read up from the USB on this television, LED television. Now we will select on the movie section, and here there is a video. We will turn this on. And we are getting the video working on the television. Right now you can also listen the sound output from the television, and video is on the screen. If I disturb the data communication on the USB 1 block, we will see, let's see what happens. If pin 1 will be turned off, data will not open, hence the USB 1 is not work. So no equipment is the signal on the television screen right now, you can see. So it is not detecting any of the USB. And if I turn this switch again, this will start and load the USB again. Here the USB has completely read again and showing on the front screen USB 1 is connected. Now if we turn off the pin 2, the data will be again open and USB will not work. So as I turned off the DP switch 2, it will not get any of the data. So for explaining this, as you can see, I will select to recover any of the data, but if I press the enter button, the data will be not retrieved because the power supply is provided to the USB so that the OS or the software of the TV or the LED TV has get that the USB is connected, but data transfer is stopped because we have created the fault by turning off the dip switch of the data transfer. If I again turn on this switch, we will get the data accordingly. In some time, here that we have getting the data, after reading the USB properly. So after proper reading of the USB, we can get all the data by turning on the data transfer fault switch as it is. So our video is now again ready to start. So that's how the USB faults can be created with the fault conditions. Now we'll see some more faults. Now to see the output of the speaker and to create the fault inside the audio output of the video that we play on the TV screen, we will see the effect on right and left audio speaker one by one using the fault which is provided on the speaker output block. So I will play the video. Here and now, using these fault switches, we will turn on right and left speaker one by one and see the effect. Verify the result of half and full subtractor. So we'll first turn off the left speaker. Right now I'm using my camera mic to give you the proper output of the mic. Here
38665A.
The left speaker is working.
So now
and right speaker,
I'm going to perform some connection
also
to verify
working.
The result of half subtractor and full subtractor.
So that's how we see both the speakers are working. Now if I turn off any of the switches from left, right or left speaker, we will see the difference in the audio output. So I will turn off the audio output from the left speaker and we see the difference in both the speakers again.
I'm going to perform the connection of half subtractor and verify
the sound
result. So as we know, the output of difference output of the half subtractor is the A XOR B, and whereas the borrow output for the
so that's how you will observing the output difference in right or left speaker. Now we will turn on the left speaker again and see the output has been blocked from the right speaker by turning off the dip switches of right side speaker. Now again we will observe the output.
So as we know, for 00 the output, the difference output of R subtractor is 0 and borrow output.
If I close both the switches, the audio output will be completely blocked. So now I am again turning off the left speaker and there is no audio output from the television. So that's how we can create the output or the fault for the audio signal as well. So that's how we create some faults in the fault using the fault switches, dip switches provided on the different sections. So similarly, you can provide any of the fault conditions in different LED driver, or you can provide fault from the video output block, display block, audio video blocks as well, while connecting all the devices for giving the input. And see when you create the fault switch by turning on the dip switch or turning off the dip switch, you will get the appropriate fault for the resembling the actual fault conditions on the LED TVs. Also, you can also connect the monitor of your PC through this VGA connector and observe the different type of faults condition as well on the monitor. For connecting the PC input, you can use this PC audio input block. So you can easily connect the monitor screen from the VGA connector and audio input from the audio input block. So there are a lot of fault switches for different blocks are provided. You can create the different faults and see the effect of the particular fault on the LED or the LED trainer board. So all the fault details and what the effect will be happen through this fault switch will be also described in the user manual. You can read out that and create the fault accordingly, so that you can easily find out the devices and which devices and which fault you can getting, so that you can easily rectify the fault by troubleshooting purpose. So that was the complete demonstration of LED TV trainer, in which I have tried to explain the complete concept of working of LED and differentiate the LCD between LCD, CRT and LED type of TVs, how the LED works and what is the main difference in LCD type of backlit and LED type of backlit TV. Also, I have tried to explain all the experiments regarding with this LED TV trainer. As I explained in this video, you can do all the experiments as I explained and describe in this video. Still you find the difficulties, you can use and refer the user manual. Also you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all type of supports. So if you like the content of this video and it is useful for you, you can press the like button and you can share this video if you find this informative to your colleagues, to your friends, to your classmates, to expand up the knowledge about the LED TV trainer. Also you can get the different and various concept videos with the practical information on our channel, which is Tesca Tech. Please subscribe our channel to get the informative videos on different practical hands-on experience. Also don't forget to press the bell button, so whenever we upload new video you will get proper notified about the new video as well. Till then, thank you for watching this video. We will meet in the next video soon.